Happy 2019, everybody. And yet another year is done. Hit or miss, I guess they never miss, huh? 2018, the year of Bongo Cats, Fortnite dances, PewDiePie vs. T-Series, and the EU trying to ruin the internet. But, of course, we are here to talk about science in 2018. Science has made progress this year, which I will try to talk through quickly in this video. Let's get right into it. So January starts, and at the third day, scientists in Rome unveil the first bionic hand, with a sense of touch that can be worn outside of the laboratory. On 5 January, researchers report images taken by the Curiosity rover on Mars showing curious rock shapes that may require further study in order to help determine whether the shapes are biological or geological. On 11 January, a NASA experiment shows how spacecraft may possibly determine their location by focusing on millisecond pulsars in space. On the 24th of January, scientists in China report in the journal Cell that the creation of 2 monkey clones using complex DNA transfer method that produced Dolly the sheep for the first time. Moving on to February. On February the 5th, researchers find additional evidence for an exotic form of water called supraionic water, which is not found naturally on Earth, but could be common on the planets Uranus and Neptune. On the 9th of February, human eggs are grown in the laboratory for the first time by researchers at the University of Edinburgh. On the 16th, scientists report for the first time the discovery of a new form of light, which may involve polaritons, that could be useful in the development of quantum computers. On the 28th, astronomers report for the first time a signal of the reionization epoch, an indirect detection of light from the earliest stars formed, about 180 million years after the Big Bang. In March, we have on March 8th, scientists report first detection of natural ice 7. Previously, it was only produced artificially. It may be common on the moons Enceladus, Europa, and Titan. On March 14th, British theoretical physicist and cosmologist Stephen Hawking dies. Next, in April, on April the 2nd, the inoperative Tiangong-1 space lab comes down over the South Pacific Ocean northwest of Tahiti. On April the 18th, NASA's transitioning exoplanet survey satellite, the TESS, is launched. On April the 25th, the Gaia 2 is released, containing data of roughly 1.7 billion celestial light sources. On 28th April, researchers report identifying 6,331 groups of genes that are common to all living animals, which may have arisen from a single common ancestor that lived 650 million years ago. Then, in May, we have on May 14th, astronomers publishing supporting evidence of a water plume activity on Europa, which could help researchers search for life from the subsurface European Ocean without having to land on the moon. Later, in June of this year, on June 7th, a cyclical seasonal variation in atmospheric methane on Mars is confirmed. On June 27th, astronomers report that Oumuamua, an object from interstellar space, is passing through the solar system, which is a mildly active comet and not an asteroid as previously thought. Moving to July, on July 11th, scientists report the discovery in China of one of the oldest stone tools outside of Africa, estimated 2.12 million years old. On 12 July, astronomers make the most precise measurements to date of the universe expansion rate, a figure of 73.5 kilometers per second per megaparsec, reducing the uncertainty to just 2.2%. On the 25th day, scientists report the discovery of a subglacial lake on Mars, 1.5 kilometers below the southern polar ice cap, and the first known stable body of water on the planet. The same day, TESS assumes operations. Skipping August, we arrive in September this year. On the 21st of September, the Japanese Hayabusa 2 probe deploys 2 landers on the surface of the large asteroid Ryugu in order for its sample return mission. Forward to October this year, and on October the 3rd, astronomers published the details of a candidate exomoon, Kepler-1625b1, suggesting it has a mass and radius similar to Neptune and orbits the exoplanet Kepler-1625b. On the 20th, the joint ESA-JAXA Baby Colombo probe is launched to the planet Mercury, and on the 30th, the Kepler telescope officially retires. Next, we arrive at November. On the first day, the Earth Biogenome Project is launched, a 10-year global effort to sequence the genomes of all 1.5 million known animal, plant, protozoan, and fungal species on Earth. On the same day, the Dawn mission finally retires. On the 14th, Barnard Star is found to have a planet orbiting it, making it the third closest planet after Proxima Centauri B and Alpha Centauri BB. On the 25th, Chinese scientists report the birth of twin girls, Lulu and Nana, as the world's first genetically edited babies. The human genes were edited to resist the HIV virus. Then, finally, December. On the 8th, China launches Chang'e 4, the first mission to land a robotic craft on the far side of the moon. On the 10th, the Voyager 2 leaves the solar system 6 years after its sister probe Voyager 1 did so. On the 18th, scientists report the earliest flowers began about 180 million years ago, 50 million years earlier than previously thought. So this is my fourth year on YouTube. This year my channel went from 18 to 30,000 subscribers, meaning that one in every 250,000 people is now subscribed to my channel. My like percentage is 93.04%. And over 7.2 million people have seen a video of mine, which is about the same as the population of Hong Kong. Collectively, you guys have watched my videos for over 49 years, which is almost half a century. To put in contrast how long that is, 50 years ago the launch of the Sputnik had just happened. So thank you guys for supporting my channel, and let's make another year of UG Science together. I hope you all had a great 2018 and will have an even greater 2019.